I'm here with boxing sensation Omar Henry, and I caught up with him and with his trainer David Ali.
Gentlemen, so Henry,
what do you think about him?
I think he's great.
Reporting.
Big smile, Omar.
Is he a future world champion?
He's the best amongst the rest.
Reporting. How are you?
Best fighter soon to be. John King and O. Henry. Remember that name.
Omar, you're 13-0. How many knockouts now?
I'm 11-0, 9 knockouts. Tomorrow, 12-0. Then I'm fighting again at the end of the month. And I'll be 13-0.
11-0, 9 knockouts. They call you Baby Kota. Why?
No.
Oh, man. Well, that's the beginning of my career. You know, I got my own style now. But because we got similar styles when I first started, but I've grown into my own style now.
You were sparring Margarito nose to nose. It was very competitive. Tell me about that in Mexico.
Oh, well, Margarito, it was good. You know, I was, helping for the fight coming up. I mean, I felt great. I was 18,000 feet above sea level. I did tremendous. It felt great, and they loved it.
What's it like to have Don King as a promoter?
It's wonderful, man. This is a legend. This is a living legend right here. And, you know, he take care of me. You know what I mean? You know, this is a guy right here, man. And, you know, he wanted the best. His record speaks for itself.
Now, Don, did you know that he has 50,000 followers on Twitter? People love him. Did you know that?
I love him. No matter who else will be there. That's me. I'm happy. How about you?
He's a great dude. So what can you tell me about Cotto Margarito? You going to tune in for that?
Yeah. Because I'll be done with my fight by the time it starts. I think it's going to be a great fight. Okay, cool. I think it's going to be a great fight. You know? May the best man win, you know?
You're working with David Ali. Tell me about that, working with David.
Oh, David, he's a great trainer. You know, his record speaks for itself, too. He
wrote
David,
you know, working with a lot of boxers
and things like that. So, you know, it was great. He got all these new techniques and worked with Victor Conte, too, and with, all the extra stuff they put in with for the different techniques and training. It's lovely. Just moved me in the best shape. You're going to see tomorrow. I'm in hell of shape. And I'm going my first big 8-round fight, things like that, Showtime. I'm ready, as you see.
How was he doing in Mexico with Margarito?
Yeah, he was exceptional. I mean, I couldn't ask for more. Robert Garcia couldn't ask for more. Tony was very grateful. It was good work for everybody involved.
Now, there's a big fight everybody's talking about. We all want to see Pacquiao Mayweather. Break it down.
Well, we seen with Pacquiao last fight. You know, he showed some vulnerableness. You know, that aura of him being unstoppable, unbeatable, kind of faded away after that fight. And a lot of people now that used to be so much on Pacquiao, they're like, oh no, Mayweather might stop Pacquiao now. Now the luster of the fight kind of died down. So, you know, this is what it is now. So, you know, it's going to be interesting though. I hope it happens still.
David, I've known Omar for a few years now. He seems very happy, very relaxed, very calm. How do you attribute that? What made him like mature more?
I think as he's getting closer to climbing up in the ranks, and he's seen the support of the fans, he's seen the support of the people in the boxing community. It's just kind of humbled him down to make sure that both feet are on the ground, and he realizes the seriousness of his work. And that, on top of the fact that what people don't know, because they see him out there a lot, he's a gym rat. He's very much a gym rat. And so working hard in the gym, but the fact that he knows what's ahead of him as far as...
It come with age. You know, I'm 24. I'll be 25 in February coming up, you know. And, you know, very grateful, very humble. I got such a big following. Shout out to all my Twitter followers and everybody, you know.
You got a lot of them.
Yeah, I know, man.
You have more than any other boxer except Mayweather, Khan, and maybe a couple more.
Yeah, I know, man. I mean, it's a blessing. That's all I can say. It's a blessing just, you know, being so well known. I have so many followers already in my career. It just shows you, you know, just a year or 2 years from now, it's going to be incredible, you know? So I'm just grateful, you know?
So last thing I got to ask you this. There was a time you hung around Floyd a lot. What's it like to hang around one of the best?
Oh, it was grateful. I always going to love Floyd, man. He took care of me. I got nothing bad to say about Floyd. Floyd is a great guy, you know? It's just an experience hanging around Floyd. He's a character, man. It's an experience hanging around Floyd. He is a character. I love Floyd. You know, he treated me with a lot of love and support, and, you know, support forever, man. Love support. glove flip.
If you win, are you going to do a backflip in the ring like you did in Mexico?
No. The ring too small. I gotta have more grass.
There you have it. Stay tuned for more. Omar Henry for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Segback reporting.
Okay.
You can follow me on Twitter, @Segback. What's your Twitter?
@OmarHenry, baby.
What's your Twitter?
All the way down.